Hi everyone, hope everyone's doing good. If anyone is still following me with my ICF project, I actually poured my basement today. So everything I'm doing with my home build is probably considered weird or unusual or not common. So one of the things I just wanted to talk about today, which I couldn't find any information really about prior to, was a lot of people pre-install their ledger boards before the pour. That's not an uncommon practice to install your ledger boards, put your bolts in so that it's basically pre-installed. You don't have to drill any holes or anything like that. So, or in this case, I could have used like a Simpson strong tie, but just because of the cost, I ended up using regular bolts. And the unusual thing that I did was I actually, and I could not find any information on this before I did it, I actually attached my trusses before I poured. So what that did was, is it actually held the top at the exact dimension I wanted. So I have the bottom screwed into the foundation. It's got concrete screws that go down in the foundation on these braces. I got a little trim piece here, if you can see it along the side, that just kind of helps, you know, any kicking out or anything on the bottom of the form. And after I poured, these walls stayed perfectly level. So they did not move at all. There really was no way for them to move. They either had to break the concrete screws out of the concrete, or they had to move the trusses up above, and that just wasn't gonna happen. So they stayed perfectly level, like spot on. I was actually surprised they didn't move at all. Now every once in a while, you could have maybe a foam block that is pushing out just a hair, and then that could throw your level off where it's not dead center, but it's, for the most part, it's pretty much dead center on these side walls. Now on the end walls, I probably made a little mistake. I didn't probably have quite as rigid vertical supporting as I should have had. I guess I could say that I did not have enough, because it moved a hair. So in the level, it's almost touching one of the lines, but it's not bad. It moved just a hair, and it honestly could have moved before, and I just didn't catch it. But other than that, I just wanted to put this information out because I could not find anybody that had installed their floor trusses before they poured. So I really had no idea. Is this a good idea? Is this a bad idea? So this will be a two-part series. The first part is how the actual pour went, and it went really good. There was no problems. It stayed where it was supposed to. It did a great job. Basically, the premise of this is you have to put in these vertical supports anyway, every 4 to 6 feet. To support the blocks anyways and put these, you know, diagonals on. So you have to do that anyways. And I thought, well, if you're doing that anyways and you got to put scaffolding up there, why not just let those hold the weight of the ledger and then use the trusses as the scaffolding? And that's what I did. And it worked really nice. Like I said, the only thing I wish I would have braced my end walls better. I will make a second part on this because the next crucial thing people are gonna ask is, well, how good did the floor end up staying level? And that, it passes the eye test. It looks like spot on, but until I actually go up there and start putting in my strong backs and seeing how level it is and how, you know, things settled out, I don't think they're gonna move. But if they do, I'll put out a second video just saying, you know, how my floor ended up working out pre-installing my trusses before I poured. One of the benefits to this is I did not attach like real heavy duty fasteners from my trusses into the concrete itself, but I put a few light connection points, I guess you would say. So what that'll kind of do is it just keeps the trusses up against the wall. It gives me a little, I can actually attach my trusses a little bit into the concrete. Not that that is necessary, but that was kind of another benefit of it. So with that, I will let everybody go. Hope everyone is having a good day. Hope everybody's doing good on their adventures. If you're waiting on a sawmill, I am very sorry. I feel for you. I know it's a very bad time at the ports, and I can only imagine the frustration that's going on with people waiting on stuff coming in from the ports. But if I have anything interesting come up, sawmilling or a house, I will post a video. But until then, I hope everyone has a good day.